Good evening. That's right. The California Department of Fish and Wildlife have released new maps that track the movement of GPS collared wolves. But ranchers and farmers who are already dealing with them on a daily basis say this effort falls short.
Peter Tira with CDFW says the new maps aim to help ranchers mitigate wolf attacks on livestock.
Our main goal was to help support our livestock producers in northeastern California. Knowledge is power.
It tracks and collects the approximate location of 14 GPS collared wolves four times a day. But CDFW says there are dozens of wolves in the area. Amarok Weiss with the Center of Biological Diversity says this new coexistence tool is helpful for all Californians.
Wolf conflicts are rare in any state with wolves, but both ranchers and wolves will benefit if we can make those conflicts even more rare by giving a heads up.
When looking at the map, you may only see a handful of wolf locators. That's because some collars may fall off, malfunction, or the animal may move beyond the range of active cells or even cross state borders. But for ranchers and officials dealing with gray wolves on a daily basis, these maps are only pointing out the obvious. Jeremiah LaRue is the Siskiyou County Sheriff.
The map is a good start. It's got some bugs, but I want to say that Fish and Wildlife is trying to put something out there.
He and Sierra County Sheriff Mike Fisher have been at the forefront of the issue and say less than a handful of wolves in their counties are being tracked.
If there isn't a GPS reading on a particular ranch, that doesn't mean that wolves aren't currently present on that ranch. It just means that one of the three collared wolves is not on that ranch.
We've estimated 70 plus wolves in our community.
Today at the Capitol, the sheriffs from Plumas and Lassen counties have joined them to meet with the Secretary of Natural Resources and Director of CDFW to discuss wolf management, sharing how frequent the attacks have become.
Sometimes it's been daily, you know, 2-3 days in a row.
But today's meeting has brought hope.
We discussed various options today on, you know, hazing and various plans.
But I felt refreshed a little bit and reassured that we are going to be heading in the right direction.
Now, the sheriffs will meet with state officials again sometime in the next week to discuss what comes next. That is the latest reporting at the Capitol covering local news that matters. Juliet Smith, Fox 40 News.
Juliet.